Today's video is a almost 3-year-old Doberman named Diesel who lives in New York City. Diesel's owner, Damir, gave me a call, told me the rundown on Diesel. So Diesel's issue is he is very dangerous to be around. It's a time bomb. So you really cannot touch him. He's touch sensitive. He appears to be a bully. So when he wants to be touched, he comes to you. Now, when he does that, he will get in you, he'll get on you, but the moment you move your hands or you try to pet him, you're gonna be in big trouble. He's coming for you. And of all things, he's a face hunter. It's extremely dangerous. And Demir's girlfriend went to pet him and went towards him and went to pet him and said, good boy. And he got her right inside, right in her jaw. So this is very dangerous.
He bit my parents twice, my mother twice, my father twice. He bit my girlfriend on her chin. The canine tooth went all the way through her mouth.
He had a behaviorist in New York. That didn't work out. Then he was getting the help of a few other trainers.
I had about 4 or 5 trainers and a behaviorist working on him. Nothing ever changed. That's why I decided to come to Florida, visit the Miami Dog Whisperer, because I saw his videos on YouTube and I've seen dogs that are like, that were 10 times worse than him, turn out into a great dogs, acting like puppies. And that's exactly the same results we're getting with Diesel. He's a good boy now, look at him. He would never do this, no. Never.
Then he was stuck and didn't know what to do. So for 2 years, he's been living with this and having to live around Diesel because of how dangerous he is. He bit Demir's dad at least 3 times, bit his mom, bit him. He's been sitting there trying to touch him and wham, right for him. So you gotta fight him off. You're fighting a huge Doberman. This guy is a beast. This is not the kind of guy you want to play around with. This is a dangerous situation. So when Demir contacted me and told me about this, we deal with these types all the time. So this is one of my specialties. So after a phone consultation, Demir decided, and after research for a few years, that he wasn't getting the right answers. And he felt the dog needed a special treatment. So we made arrangements. Demir is here now in Miami. So he traveled from New York to Miami for 2 weeks so that we can rehab Diesel. So I'm gonna give you a little process here of what's been going on and things we've been doing and what we've achieved. And I believe as of today's class, we've done 8 classes so far. So it's been straight about 8 days. So we've come a long way in 8 days. So I'm gonna give you a little tour here, and imagine there's a lot of hours and hours and hours of footage I had to go through, but I'm gonna give you the scope and the idea of what we've been doing as far as his rehabilitation. Now, keep in mind, one of the biggest things and hurdles that Demir went through trying to find help was that none of the other trainers or behaviorists were willing to do the things that it takes to get into Diesel's head and start to rehab him. So this is where we're all gonna start, and it's pressure. Now this is our first day here, and right away, we know that Diesel has touch sensitivity, space sensitivity. I mean, he's a mess when it comes to do not come in his space, do not go near him, don't go try to pet him like that at all, not even the owners. So right away, I'm gonna test him, and I wanna see how touchy-feely he is about his zones. So here, you're gonna see me start to press into him with my body and see how far I can push this and how nervy he's gonna be about this.
So we're gonna stand him for a sec. And he's gonna hold the line a little shorter, just if he can't leap.
Leave the tension on the leash, or?
Well, a little bit.
Now you can see as soon as I start moving my body towards his, he's already moving sideways and trying to get away from me, getting a little jumpy. Then here, when I push him too far and I just keep moving into him and trying to touch him, he eventually finally backs out and gets out of there and comes around and faces me. Now, this is one of those things while doing this testing. When you're gonna deal with aggression cases, and we get this every day all the time, and I don't care what trainer, behaviorist, what level they are, 99% of the time, the reason why dogs don't get rehabbed properly is because they're misdiagnosed. And Diesel's a perfect example of this. Everybody's telling Demir that this guy's a tough guy and he's dominant, he's a bully. It's the opposite. He's a chicken at heart, but he has had his way for 3 years. Nobody's ever pushed him. He's just become a bully. He has never, that's why his nerve sensitivities got worse and worse and worse. So he's really weak, extreme opposite of what most people's diagnosis of him was. So if you don't diagnose it right, you can't treat it right. So what has to happen in this rehab, it's all about his nerves. And it's making sure you're rehabbing those nerves and getting his nerves to overcome. So the complication is to try to explain on video. This very complex to understand and try to really give people a grasp of this, how much is really happening and what has to happen with this. When you have this kind of nerve problem, the brain and the nerves, they're connecting in a certain way. So since he never has gone through pressure, his nerves are jumbled. He can't take touches, he can't take distance, he can't take all these things. So what happens is, if a movement happens in the wrong way, or a touch goes to the body and he jumbles, these kind of guys strike. And it's not intended strikes. It's not an intentional strike that the brain was thinking that now it's like, oh, I'm gonna get you. It's a counter. So it's a nerve reaction to a response of the brain into an attack. So, and people take it personal and they go, oh, you see, but he attacks. No, he's being pressed, his nerves start to go, they start to fray, they push, and then the mind goes. So what you're doing in rehab is you're getting the nerves tougher to be able to hold themselves. Now the brain in rehab has to now disconnect from the nerves and the nervous system. Meaning you have to teach him in rehabilitation and therapy, when he getting those nerves going, that he cannot just be emotional and let it go without thought. Now he's got to put thought to it and stop his nerves that he feels and not follow through on what his nerves are telling him. So there are some things in the video you're gonna see, he's shaking a little bit, but there's no strikes. He's actually very passive, but his nerves are going. So his mind is one thing, his body's another. The body will come with time and getting the nerves to get stronger and develop. So, and very quickly in 1 week, we've come a long, long way on getting those nerves tight and getting that brain in check. So here, when I press Diesel a lot, I go in and I'm pushing and I come around him and pet him from his rear, which he has a big problem with us, petting his back and down. His nerves go, he gets tense because I flushed him already out of where he was going. He was telling me he didn't want any more of it. So he fled instead of fought. Another perfect example of weakness, not dominant. Flight instead of fight first, and it wasn't until I pushed and pushed and pushed, and then he cracked. And he bit me. When he bit me, it was a big one too. That bite hurt and I still have a bruise, I think, back here. My wife said yesterday, that was a week ago. This is a guy who doesn't know how to bite, doesn't have bite development. And in my big jacket and my suit, he went and hit me right here for hitting it, and that bite hurt a lot. So he put a lot into that. And that was all that winding up pressure, those nerves, and him trying to get out of it, but couldn't anymore, and just had to let it fly out of fear. So, diagnosis, the right one, critical when you're doing, when you're working with aggressive, fearful dogs in any way. You have to understand what you're diagnosing if you are gonna get to the end of something and really help a dog. So, step one, we got the proper diagnosis and we know what we need to do now to hit this. Diesel always has a problem with being in close, anywhere to human. He does not like coming in. He does not like his space invaded. It bothers him a lot because of the fear problem he has, the insecurity. So here, when Demir went to hug him, which he never does in New York, and he would never do without a muzzle on, because he would lose his face if he did that. So here, when he went to hug him, Diesel attacks him. That's right. And this is the other thing about the muzzle. When doing muzzle work, if he's gonna do it, he's gonna do it muzzle or no muzzle, just like you saw right there, what he did to Demir. When Demir went like, go around to hug him, and he didn't like it, muzzle on, he let Demir know for sure he did not like that. And if that muzzle wasn't on, Demir would have got it right in the head. So when you're doing these processes of playing with these dogs, the muzzle's critical because you have to keep safety. So in most cases, the muzzle's not going to stop a dog from showing what they feel or acting out in any way, most of the time. So it's very important that we keep the safety as we work him through the process. Now, because he attacked Demir in that scenario, we had been doing a lot of touch therapy and working on his body and his nerves. Now, because he attacked him in that spot, I want Demir to go back to that spot, and we're gonna replay this again and see what we have after some touch therapy and development. I believe it was the next day, of the spot that he attacked him in. And we're gonna replay this in the same scenario, exactly how this went down, the same touches. Thank you. Mm-hmm. He's shaking like a leaf.
But, no growl.
No. He didn't growl, right? So I didn't hear anything. Yeah. And he just walked into you, right?
Yeah. But he was with open eyes.
Yeah, no. That he was uncomfortable. But he checked it. And he's right now he's trying to get through it. But that's why we got to do this. Because every time he shakes like that, it's a good thing for us. And then he's going to give you paw. Because he's okay with it. He just has to settle those nerves. He's accepting it. Right? And then, so, all right, he even walked in again. Good. And he walked in again, deeper. Now the thing when you're working with this, you hear me telling Demir go backwards, and I'm having Demir make Diesel work for this. He's starting to want Demir's affection and attention. He's giving him paw a lot. So since he has problems with this, we want to know we're clearing this up. It's very important that he can take this or we cannot rehab completely. So I'm having Demir move backwards, and I'm making Diesel, against what he would do normally, want to come into Demir's space and get that head into his lap area and in his body, coming in for the affection. So when you see Demir going backwards here, Diesel's actually coming in and following, and on his own would start coming in. And if Demir comes forward at all doing this, if that would happen in the past, bam, for any movement forward, for any touching, for any hand movements over, any of this, it would have made Diesel set off. Now, if you go back a little bit, lean back a little bit, I want to see him come in, and you're going to lean over, and you're going to do again, and just, good boy, and then you come out. Go far, he comes with you. He's volunteering. He's like, hey, don't go too far away. Don't make me chase you. It's good. We leave him there, we don't have to pressure him so much, because he did it, and he's actually looking for it. We got what we wanted.
See, now I even had my legs over him.
So that went beautifully. It's perfect. No aggression, no growling, letting him do it and wanting to be in there with him. They're forming a bond now. Diesel's trusting Demir now instead of pushing him away and not allowing him and becoming aggressive to him. All right, so after that touch therapy stuff going well, Demir gets on the floor, no suit, and Diesel has no muzzle on. This is the first time that we're ever going to experiment with this with no equipment. Demir gets on the floor, he's laying there, and Diesel comes in, and he's right in there by the legs. Right, and he didn't come all the way in, but close enough, we're in between the legs, and Demir petting him, which he could never do before with that distance and on the floor, vulnerable, and Diesel not attacking. So this is a very tricky moment. Very dangerous for Demir.
right.
No, I know, he's gorgeous. Love him.
And now he's so shiny.
I know. On the film, when I'm looking through, I just see the shine off his coat.
He loves to be caressed.
It's getting over that tension of being there.
It takes time.
Yeah, yeah, but he's doing really well. Like, from a day or two ago doing that.
Even me, starting feeling comfortable with him, but yeah. Totally unprotected.
Like right now, the mirror would not have done that without the muzzle.
No, it takes time.
Yes,
him.
Yes, yes.
You know,
but I'm starting to feel him too. That's why I'm doing it.
That's right. Because he's not in a tense state and he's not looking at you like that. He's coming in okay.
And it worked out beautifully. So that was perfect to see. Another tricky moment. Now, the mirror is sitting right in front of the fence, talking to somebody over the fence. And there's only a little gap between him and the fence. And Diesel, being that weak in nerve problems and space problems, it'd be very, very difficult for Diesel to want to be in that space, especially be touched. Would he even put himself in that space? Normally, he would not. And even like Demir was saying, he would never even come when he was called, generally. So you see here, Demir's going to call him, and Diesel gets right into that small space.
Diesel, here.
He would never get in this place.
He'd never do that? Like, stuck between the fence and you?
He would never come.
You would have never allowed him to.
He wouldn't come.
You see his face, you see his state when he's in there. He has no issue with you right now. No, right, no conflict.
No.
No, he's doing great. And this, when you were facing here and he had to come in here, I said, that's a tough moment for him.
Yeah.
Because he's going to have to push himself between the fence and you. He's trapped. That's right. That's right.
But it's everything else also outside. He's sick.
Bye, take care.
He's seeking for my being next to him. Now he knows, if I look over there, that's not good. But if I stay.
Right.
So it's kind of a combination of things that are building it up.
Yes, there.
Poor, when I squat down, but then I would not, you see, now I went back and touching him.
Right.
Before I could let him squat, he feels like when I get close to him, he will come lick my face. But then at this point, I can't reach out with my hands. I just got to let him finish.
Right, like let him be and let him do what he wants with no pressure whatsoever. Yeah. It's
now
on his terms.
I went back and pet him,
you would touch him and doing his, and he was just fine.
And I know to a lot of people this might not seem like a big deal. This is huge. One, Diesel flew when he was called, which wasn't normal before we started. He gets into that tiny space, which is the danger zone for Demir, especially being trapped between something tight with the dog does not like at all. Being right in front of him and Demir kneeling down, being face level before, extremely dangerous. Now, Diesel came in, licked him in the face, and Demir pet him, which he would never do before, because that's when he would get attacked. And then Diesel stays in there. Perfect. And no aggression whatsoever, no thought of it. Before would have been instant aggression. And here we were teaching Diesel to jump up on a table on command, because he had a little bit of anxiety about the table and staying on it. So here we taught him to go to the table, and then Demir, at face level, no muzzle, no nothing, kisses him in the eye.
And if you want to pet him a little bit too, I go, good boy. Yes, you see that? Right.
Good boy. Good.
All right, now we get the automatic takeoff to the table. Right? He doesn't need your help. He knows it's coming. He wants to be there. Good. Now you see.
When I kissed his eye.
Oh shit! I think I got it.
Yeah, you got it. You pointed this way, but you didn't see it. Like totally mellow.
Yeah, no, he's good.
Free.
Good.
And Demir points out how crazy that was. He could actually get in his face now and kiss him in his eye and not get it right in the face. Any defensive posturing. It's beautiful. It's exactly what we want to see. Perfect. All right, now, we have to go through some more touch therapy for some other little things and angles. Diesel hasn't been brushed in almost 3 years. You cannot brush that guy. And Demir was not gonna put himself in a dangerous spot trying to brush him. He knew if he went to brush Diesel, it was on and he was gonna get it. Avoid the fight. So Diesel hasn't been brushed almost his whole life. It's been years. So we're building up to this, that he needs to get brushed. The next step after that, we're gonna show him video. He hasn't had a bath in a year and a half because that would be a major issue. And Demir does not need to get in a fight with this guy. You gotta let him just live dirty and stinky because the fight that's gonna happen with this is way too dangerous. The only time he got bathed in his life was a year and a half ago. And that was because a skunk sprayed him and Demir had to get the skunk scent off him. That's the only reason he got bathed, and it was a fiasco, Demir said. So that's why he hasn't bathed him ever again, and it's only been once in his life because of the fight that this guy puts up. So we're gonna also bathe him. So we're going through this process of the touch stuff so we can get to the brushing, then the bathing. So here we go.
He gets...
Did you ever touch him there?
A little bit the other day, but he was tense. Right now he's relaxed.
Which yeah, is he's very relaxed.
His belly.
Very relaxed.
For his belly to be like this? Not shaking, right?
No, no. His eyes are completely like...
I want to lean my whole arm, you know, like to feel the pressure.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do there when I switch to the front?
I'm watching him too. His eyes just stayed like in a lazy, relaxed, like he's in a sleep state. Good. Good. Yeah.
Look, he's moving in.
Yeah, no, no, he wants more. He wants to stay with you, he wants to stay with you, he wants to stay with you. Because now he's trusting. He's trusting, he's getting a good sensation of being close to you,
mm-hmm.
Not threat. That's the new under there. I was watching, because you were kind of moving that skin over there. A brief second, but not...
Nothing, start touching him.
Sure.
And with no protection. Yeah.
And if you pet him there, well, that would have been the arm over right there when he was petting it in your face there, that arm to go touch him, that would have been a trigger, right?
Yeah. No, even this, what I did with my...
Right, with the head bumping him?
Yeah.
Good, very good.
All right, so the touching all over the body underneath it, Demir could never do, especially Diesel on his side. He can never even touch him like this, ever, if Diesel's on his side. Dangerous, dangerous. So with the muzzle on, you still gotta worry about the thrashing, what's his state of mind, there's a lot of things. So all the touching underneath the body, everywhere that Demir could never do, not even with a muzzle on before. We were good. Now it's time to move on to his tough things. This is gonna be Diesel's first brushing in his life. And first we're doing it with the muzzle on, just to make sure that we have safety. Here we go.
So you want to brush them here, you want to brush them there.
What she wants.
Yeah. Yeah, it's okay.
Basically, once he gets the trust, he would pretty much accept anything.
Right, right, right. Because once he knows that he can trust you and he doesn't feel that paranoia, now he's going to go to sleep.
Arched?
But his eyes?
What's that mean?
No,
Well, sometimes
arched.
When he gets arched, it can be a little tension, but right now he's fine. He's good. No, he's relaxing like a... Make him come in. We're gonna hold off and make him. Right. He's closing that zone.
Oh yeah, by himself.
Uh huh.
Without treats, without anything.
Right.
Should I get some gel tomorrow? Put some gel.
Good hairdo. Not to mark.
Beautiful. Now we want to proof this and make sure that without the muzzle on, his reactions are still the same.
Diesel's first brushing.
Yeah.
First brushing
without
the muzzle.
Good. Very good. And if you, he's going to start sitting down. He's like, more.
today it's like a spa for him.
Yeah.
I got my ear all, my hand, my finger all the way in.
Touch good, brushing perfect, he's loving it. Now, he hates water. So now we're gonna get the water on him, and then we're gonna give him his first bath in a year and a half, and see what happens. And again, muzzle first to make sure that everybody's safe when this happens.
From the feet, you said?
Let's see. Let's see if you go over them and you just kind of gently tinkle them. Right. Good, he's relaxing. He's falling asleep.
Should we dig for the head too?
Neck. And that's what I'm saying too, if you take the muzzle off, it will also have a, he's not gonna do it. He's so relaxed. So without the muzzle.
You know what I have? You're gonna come back here?
Oh, it's okay.
This is good, they're all in water. I just wanna make sure I rinse it off.
Yeah, just rinse off good. So what you can do is if you get the suit on, finish the rinse. And we'll make sure we really, really get all the soap out of the undercoat without the muzzle on. So you can dig under there and try to get some soap out.
Went perfect, no issues whatsoever. Now we're gonna take muzzle off. And again, we're gonna test this without the muzzle on, see how it goes.
So you, either you can
what keep me, rinsing a little bit.
Yeah, that's what I say. Just keep rinsing them and rub them like if he had shampoo on him, and just kind of act as if you're bathing them the same. Yeah, and he did that with the muzzle. Every time you would bend in the on the sides. Yeah, but he's okay.
A little bit of shaking.
Yeah, he was shaking before too. His back legs were shaking when you were taking the soap off him. But his eyes, right now, he's okay.
Can they do this a little bit?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, mm-hmm. Because you got to push that nerve a little bit. So you want to know if you dig in there. The more you're digging, the more sleep he's going into. And he's going to sleep.
A good boy you are. A daddy's good boy. I want to add noise, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Well, because when you jerk the hose, when you pull the hose from behind him, he went... Do his next bad, we towel him.
Beautiful, perfect, it couldn't go better. The brushing, the bathing, absolutely perfect. So now, the mirror is gonna do all of the above that Diesel could not do a week ago before he came to me. He bathed him, now he's gonna towel dry him, and he's gonna brush him all in one shot.
Wow, look at this shiny now.
No, no, he looks good. The
first time I feel it being wet.
Want you to do. Mm-hmm. You're gonna back up one step, and I want you to shake the towel. And we can brush him. So we get all three of his little phobias in one shot.
Likes it?
Yeah, no, he's loving that. The brush right now is his favorite. The beginning when you start bathing him, he went into that state of that kind of gonna go to sleep. Mm-hmm. And right now when the brush came out, he's going into that little, oh, feels good.
The brush is good, no, because he's used to it, I guess. He loved it the first time.
When he gets over the touch sensation mm-hmm. of that nervous jumping, mm-hmm. the body will soothe. And then any touch like that, it's not going to make him jump and crinkle. It's going to make him go into the relaxed state like a normal dog. Mm-hmm. Right now he's going to fall asleep.
Good boy.
Good.
It's beautiful. No issues whatsoever with all the things that Diesel would have fought on in the past, and Demir never would have been able to do. Absolutely perfect. Exactly what we want to see. All right, there's one last thing, and this one is just as bad, if not worse, than most of them. When you get a guy like this, again, diagnosing, they can be very similar looks to a trainer or a behaviorist when looking at these things. Diesel will not lay down. So the previous training that he's had in the past, he would never do a down command. And that is very, very common on dogs who have severe nerve problems. They do not trust. So they become big fighters when you try to make them submit to the floor and make them vulnerable. So it appears as dominant behavior. It's actually fearful behavior. So they're very difficult to get into a down. They will not do it through food generally. You would have to use a lot of force, even as a puppy. So that's a tough, tough thing. So Demir stayed away from it, and we're not going there. It doesn't matter to us. I'm not going to force Diesel into that. It's not going to help our rehab. And you can see already, without that, we've cracked him in all the areas that Demir really had a problem with him and any aggressive tendencies without that. So no need for that. But just as a diagnosis, but Diesel absolutely has a phobia with laying down even without being told. So what Demir is telling us, the only time that Diesel will ever lay down around them is if he's across the house and they're nowhere close. If they're out in a field, Diesel will go all the way down a field and lay down all the way down there. Now, when he watches you from across the field or across the room, the moment you step in his direction, he jumps up and you're like 50 yards away. That's how paranoid this guy is about being in a submissive state. So this is a biggie for us. We have to cross this hurdle because it's very dangerous. It's because when people, he lays down and you go close to him, you know he's coming for you. Especially he's a face hunter. So here you're gonna see with the muzzle on, Diesel voluntarily, which he would never do before, started laying next to Demir and Demir being able to pet him. Never, he would be able, first he would never lay down next to him, then touch him would cause an aggressive act, and he's taking it beautifully and just letting it be. Now.
All right, now he went down, that's a trickier.
He would never lay down next to me.
No?
I mean, the way he is, there's no way you make him lay down next to you. He doesn't even go on, that's the only command that I couldn't do it with him. He does down. Not want to down. You enjoying this now?
No, he's relaxed. He's so that's something he'd never do.
This is the first time laying down next to me and I can touch his back. Because even from a standing point, I told you, when I touch his back, he turns around. And
then here, we have a different version. One thing is to the side. Diesel here is actually submitting to Demir. He's coming into him, which we were having the issue with in the beginning that he didn't want to do. He's coming in and he's laying ahead of him, in front of him, which is a big deal for Diesel.
That never would happen, right?
Not in front of me. I kind of knew this was going to happen right now.
He looked like he was going to... And petting him like that would be dangerous?
Oh, yeah.
Like, that would be a...
There's no way. When he's so close to you and want to reach out to pet him, if you keep a distance and your head away, you know, you might get away with some things. But then, like I told you, you know, he comes to me and he wants to be pet, but then I just give him that look from basically far like this, and there's no way that you could be able to put your head like this, or your hand all the way over. No way.
He's very relaxed.
Never. He would never lay down. Never lay down. Huh. Like, unless it's a couch and he's sleeping.
Uh-huh.
Like, you take him out or you out or somewhere, he would never, ever, ever lay down on the floor.
And then he's just laying down in front of him. That is a big, big deal for this dog. That means he's letting go. He's letting go of paranoia. He's trusting. We got the nerves to be stable, that he can lay down and just let go and give in, and he's just fine. And Demir's touching him as well. No problem on his back. You would be wham! He would never let you in there or touch him or him be at you. So this dog has come a long, long way in a week. And then, here with no muscle, voluntarily Diesel came to Demir after our training session, after he was put through a lot of pressure. He voluntarily went to Demir, laid there down at his feet, which he would never do. And you see Demir with a brush that Diesel would never have let him do before, brushing him at his feet and no aggression whatsoever.
So now this is okay if I decided to do it.
Right, right. He's there relaxing in front of you. I give.
I don't want to give too much.
Right, because you're going to get. But it's good that he got a little, for being there with you, a little comfort. Now, one, he never would have laid in front of you. Two, he's going to get brushed, which he couldn't be brushed in 3 years.
See, for a second, he told me what's happening now. He had that flat backward.
Yeah, he was striking. Just a tiny little second.
Very tiny.
Yeah, yeah. That was a paranoia. And then he got relaxed.
What is he now seeking for more?
Damn this thing. And then you do his head when he's there.
Brush. My friend's dog, he was, I told you how he was.
Absolutely beautiful. Beautiful to watch, it's beautiful to view, see this dog let go, start to be normal, and just relax and bond with his owner. Be one, be relaxed, have a good time, enjoy the touching, the petting, the caressing. You can see when he gets brushed, this guy goes into a different state and he just gets in that relax. He's never had it in his life before. So we're getting there. He's come a long, long way in just 7-8 days. So till next time, Miami Dog Whisper.
I mean, look at him. There's no leash, there's no muzzle anymore. It's not like, all right, I'll let you pet me and then get away, whatever. But look at him. Never. No, we did a great job, Richard. Great job. I mean, you did a great job. I was just assisting. Good boy. You're a good boy. Huh? More?
Good night, Diesel.
Good night, Diesel.